If your Squarespace e-commerce is selling to multiple different countries with different currencies, you absolutely must have a currency converter. Now, Squarespace doesn't have one included, and I did not like the other options out there. I think they felt like widgets, they weren't reliable, they didn't look good, they didn't take into account all the different features that were needed. So here is my currency converter for Squarespace 7.1. Let's start by installing it. I'm gonna go to code injection and I'm gonna copy paste the plugin code in, click save, and now the currency converter has been installed. That did not take very long. So let's take a look at code injection and see how we can change our currency list. So here we have a simple list with currencies, and we can add, remove, and change the order of your currencies. So this list will determine what this list is going to be. So let's say we have Japanese clients. Let's add the Japanese yen here. Click save. Now we can see that the Japanese yen has been installed. It really couldn't be any easier. We've spent a lot of time making this reliable, so it'll work in all kinds of different scenarios. So for example, if we head to the cart page and we're looking at the Canadian dollars, it's gonna work even if I, for example, change the quantity, and it's not gonna break and show the store default currency. Same with, for example, variants for products. I created a product where different variants have different prices. So you can see that it's smartly displaying from price. So if we turn this to the small one, we see the price for the small converted. And if we take a look at the medium one, we see the price for the medium one. Now, of course, if you change the currency, so let's see prices in Japanese yen. If we change the currency and then move on to a different page, for example, it's gonna always remember. So even if we would close the website and then come back later, it's gonna keep showing the currency that we have chosen. I've spent a lot of time making the positioning of these selectors, both for desktop and for mobile, as clean and nice as possible, so they would really feel something like something seamless that Squarespace had designed. So let's take a look at the desktop selector. You can see that the space that it takes is very nicely taking the vertical space like the social media icons and the cart page. For the desktop, to make this pixel perfect, I've included a vertical offset, which you can tweak. So currently, by default, it's -3 pixels to make this perfect. But if you need to tweak it, you can. So let's turn this to 10. You can see that we can move it up and down so it will be pixel perfect in your website as well, regardless of your design. While I'm here with these few custom selections, I'm gonna demonstrate the rounding option. So I've included an option so you can choose if you want to have sharp corners or rounded corners, depending on your overall style for your website design. So let's turn this up into something pretty intense, just so you can see the rounded corners. So you can also go with something very subtle, like 4. For a slight rounding. And this is smart because the same rounding will be applied to the feedback pop-up that's gonna appear when you change currencies. And of course, the same rounding will be applied to the mobile currency selector as well. Let's take a look at the mobile currency selector. So the problem is that we often, for most designs, do not have enough space here to fit a currency converter. So I've opted for this hovering option. Now, to make this better and more flexible and not be in your way, I have added a few tweaks you can use. So one option, we can make it only appear when this navigation menu is opened. So I can turn on this switch, mobile switch, show prices only when the navigation is open, just by turning this option to true, kind of like turning it on and off. And now you can see we're not seeing the currency converter on a mobile unless we open the navigation menu. And for this one, I added this very subtle, small animated effect, both because, well, it looks really nice, but also it grabs your attention. So you will subconsciously see that, hey, some element moved. So it will grab your focus and you're more likely to see the currency converter. Now, we also have the option to move it from the right side to the left side just by switching this little switch to true. So make it left side instead of right. So we can put it on the left side. For example, if you're using the Facebook Messenger or maybe you have a chat here, you don't want them to overlap. So I have included this option to make the user experience better and more flexible. Usually I like to have it here because most people are right-handed, not everyone, but most people. So the right-hand side thumb has easier time reaching here. Another pretty creative option was something that a buyer of my plugin requested, and I thought it was a fantastic idea. And that is the option to only show the mobile currency converter on pages that are e-commerce pages. So the product grid, a product page, any post with a product block, or the cart page. So for example, here in terms and conditions, I want this to be easy to read. We are not seeing any products, so we don't need to show the currency converter, as it might get a little bit in the way of reading. But once we switch to a shop page, now we will see the currency converter. So this is also an optional design you can pick and choose. So maybe you don't want your blog posts to show this currency converter, but it's smart. So if any of your blog posts have a product block embedded inside them, then the currency converter would be showing if the option is enabled to hide this on non-product pages. Okay, let's talk about this little feedback modal. So in other currency converters, I didn't like the feeling of turning to another currency, but not getting any feedback. So you necessarily don't know if something happens. And in user experience design, we always want to give the user some kind of feedback so they kind of feel that, okay, the switch worked, it did something. And because of this, I have created this little kind of a pop-up modal feedback dialogue here in the bottom. It's fully responsive. So if we change the currency here, it's actually gonna be in front of the selector, so it won't overlap in an annoying way. You can probably see that both of these, both the currency selector on mobile, as well as the feedback modal pop-up, both align pixel perfectly with the Squarespace default margins. So if we adjust the size of the screen, you can see that it's perfectly aligning with whatever the margin is, even if the margin becomes larger, just so it'll look nice. And again, like something that Squarespace themselves designed and not like a cheap widget that you just added to your website. Let's talk about the colors. So in this demo site, as you can see, the colors for the header are pretty wild, and that's because I want to make a point. So as you can see, the color for the other elements links on the header is also the color for the currency selector. So let's click edit, edit the header, and choose a different style. So maybe, something like this. Click save. So now, as you can see, the currency converter is no longer the neon green, just like all the other elements are not neon green, they are black. So I've coded it in a way so it'll automatically use the same color just to make it look nice and prevent you from needing to write custom CSS or adjust the colors manually. So just to get a little bit nerdy, we have some Squarespace defined variables like the the navigation link color, which is going to depend on your theme and your color scheme. And we are using this automatically. So you can indeed just copy paste the currency converter in, and it's going to handle a lot of these positioning and color things perfectly automatically for you. Now, your clients are sometimes in a little bit of a hurry and they may not understand everything perfectly. So for this, I have included this currency converter disclaimer. So this is something that you get with the product and you'll be able to copy paste to your website. So what this is saying is that the transaction will be processed in your store's default currency, because when we go to the checkout, we no longer can add custom code there. So all the payments will be done in the currency that you have chosen for your website. But you get this nice disclaimer that's explaining that if the currency rate isn't perfect and maybe the bank of the buyer may add their own conversion rate or extra charges and that you are not responsible for them, that it's just like a tool to help them see prices, estimates more nicely. So to explain the checkout thing, so let's say that we have a customer looking at the prices in Japanese yen. So just like we have stated in the terms and conditions here, and when you switch a currency, how this modal tells that we will show price estimates in the currency, but you will still pay in the store currency. And also the cart page has one more disclaimer explaining prices are converted from the store currency to the currency they have selected. And this is also automatic. With today's current rate, actual payment will be made in US dollars for total of the normal price. Just to make it clear. But now when we go to the actual checkout, the Squarespace payment page, we do not have access to this page, so we cannot add any custom code, so the currency converter will not be enabled here. So for this reason, I have added those extra text disclaimers and pop-ups and the cart page explanations. So for this page, we cannot add any custom code because it would be a security risk for Squarespace, as custom code could potentially watch the credit card numbers being typed. So we cannot add any text here, code, and we cannot do the currency converter. But up until this point in product pages, product grid, the cart page, the currency conversions will be available. All right, let me know you if you have any questions, any feedback. I hope this was a nice kind of explanation on how the plugin works and how I feel it's a lot better design than the other currency converter plugins for Squarespace. And I hope that you will try it out. All right, thanks so much for watching, and get in touch if you have any thoughts, ideas, feedback, questions. Okay, until next time.